Hi children, how are you all? I hope you all are enjoying your holidays, right? But somewhat little bit is important for studies also. So please watch the video for today's class. Okay? Yeah, class of subject science. Okay, yesterday, what in the last class what we have discussed? Have you remembered anything? Yes, we have discussed about the parts of a seed or internal parts of a seed. What we have learned yesterday? Internal parts of a seed. Once again, we will go through that, and afterwards we will start today's class. Okay. And what is this? This is the seed. This is the seed. And what is this outer covering part? Outer covering part is called as a seed coat. This is what we have done. What is the other name of the seed coat? Which is the outside of the seed is called seed coat. And what we call the other name of the seed coat is testa or testa. This is what we have done. What is this middle part here? This is called as hilum, where we can connect to the fruit. The fruit is connected to a plant with the help of this hilum. Next one, what we have learned? Yes, right here, the leaf-like structure and embryo will be there here. Okay, this leaf-like structure is called, what we have learned yesterday, leaf-like structure. Pumpule. Leaf-like structure is the pumpule. And the remaining part is called as a cochlea. And your root-like structure called radicle. Root. Leaf. Okay. Yesterday we have learned about the parts of the internal parts of the seed, and the leaf-like structure is called the pumpule, and it is called as a shoot system which is inside the seed. And here you can see small white color structure is a radicle, and it is called as a root. Okay, root system you can see. And here you can see the middle part, which is called as a hilum. Use it to join the fruit from the seed to a plant. Okay, this is the outer part. What is that one? Seed coat or testa. Then what is this one? This whole part? Food storage. And this is called as a cotyledon. Yesterday we have learned about cotyledons also. Yes? What is the use of the cotyledon? Use it to store the food and nourishes the seed. Okay, how many types of cotyledons we have learned yesterday? Two types. One is the monocotyledon and the second one is dicotyledon. Some of examples like a maize, rice are the examples of monocotyledon. Mono means one, di means two. Monocotyledon's examples are maize and rice. Dicotyledon's example, groundnut, peas, all types of grains and cereals come under dicotyledon. This was the yesterday's class. We have learned each and every part of a seed and functions of a seed. We have learned yesterday. Today we are going to learn about the interesting topic, that is factors affecting germination. What is today's topic? Factors affecting germination. affecting germination. Okay, today's topic was factors affecting germination. Yesterday we have known that what is the meaning of the germination also, right? Yes. Will you tell me once again? If the seed is getting enough air, water, and sunlight, then the from the seed to a new plant is coming. That process is called as germination. Today we are going to learn about factors. What are the factors and how it is affecting the germination? Why seed is not going into a new plant? That all we are going to learn. For the seed, soil is needed or not? First thing, yes, we need the soil. Soil is not needed for germination. For germination, what are we doing here? Soil is not needed. Okay, without soil, how can a plant grow? Yes, I am talking about the only germination. Means from a seed to get a small seedlet or the small plant. We should not have the soil also. If we are not having soil also, we can get a germination. But if the soil is there, it provides water and minerals to seed. See here, if the soil is there or not there also, germination process will start. And one more thing, if the soil is there, if the suppose seed is inside the soil, it provides water and minerals to the seed, and some temperature also can be provided by the soil. Now these are the things we have learned. If the soil is there or not, germination process will start. So now today we can know the factors affecting germination by four ways of testing test tubes. We are going to test the seed, whether what are the conditions are affecting the germination. Now I am going to show you with the help of a diagrams. Yes, this is the first test tube. And next we are going to take four test tubes. Test tube B. Okay, test tube C. Test tube D. These are the four test tubes we have taken. Next, what we are going to test? Whether the seed is going to germinate or not. So we have taken the four test tubes, and in each test tube we are going to add seeds. Okay, this is the seed. Okay, these are the seeds already we have inserted. Next, what we were doing for the first test tube, seeds kept with a moist cotton. Here we are going to keep seeds with a moist cotton. Means some water with a cotton. Next, in a warm temperature. We are using temperature also. Now here we are going to give for the first test tube moist cotton with a temperature. Tube A has all right conditions such as water, oxygen, and suitable temperatures. Okay, C is kept in the moist cotton. Now we have kept in the moist cotton with the temperature. So the seed is getting water, air, and oxygen. They are getting the oxygen and the temperature we have provided. And next, all the conditions are there. So here the seeds will going to germinate. Water, air, sunlight are needed for germination. We have given moist cotton. It is a water. And next here the tube is having all type of air. So it will going to germinate. Air is there, so oxygen will be there. Oxygen or air I am writing here. Okay. Moist cotton, air and temperature. So every condition is there. So the seeds of A test tube is going to germinate. What about the B test tube? Yes. Seeds kept in the and the temperature I have written here. At 25 degrees Celsius. Now for here, moist cotton is there. But in cold temperature, minus or at 0 degrees Celsius. They have given at 0 degrees. Water is there, temperature is not there. So the seeds will not germinate. Water and air is there, but the temperature is not there. So for the B test tube, no seeds will be going to germinate. What about the third one here? Yes, no dry cotton. We have used a dry cotton. For the both the test tube A, we are using moist cotton. For the test tube B also, we are using moist cotton. When coming to the test tube C, we are using dry cotton. Okay. And the same temperature is like a room temperature, 25 degrees Celsius. We have given the temperature, but no water at all. Water is not there. Air is there and temperature is there, but water is not there. So will the seeds germinate? No, seeds cannot be germinated because we want three conditions. Air is required, water is required, and the temperature is also required. So B seeds, C seeds cannot be germinated. Next, coming to the D. Here the D seeds kept in the boiled water. D seeds are kept in the boiled water. These are the boiled water they have put inside the test tube. And here they use an oil also. At the certain part of the test tube, they use an oil. Oil prevents the oxygen. What do oil do? Oil prevents the oxygen in the test tube. Here the water is very hot. So, oxygen, lack of oxygen, no air. Temperature is there, water is there, but no air is there. So, fourth test tube, D is not going to generate. Which seeds are generated? Not only test tube, A seeds are generated. Moist cotton and the air temperature, everything is there. So seeds has generated in the test tube A. When compared to the test tube B, we have used at a cold temperature, that is 0 degrees Celsius. Moist cotton we have used and next in the cold temperature. We have not given the temperature for the seed. So the seed has not grown into a new plant or not germinated. Coming to the third one, test tube C. We have given the temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius. At 25 degrees Celsius, we have given with the dry cotton. If the water is there only, then the seeds will get germinated. But we have given dry cotton. If it is a smooth, wet cotton or the moist cotton, it will be germinated. But we have given here dry cotton. So, temperature is there, air is there, but water is not there. So, in the test tube C also, seeds will not be germinated. Coming to the test tube B. Oil, first they have given, seeds are inside the test tube and the seed, below, above the seeds, we have given hot water or the
water, boiling water.
And on that, again, we are using oil also. So oil reduces the air or the oxygen. So boiling water means temperature we have given, water we have given, but there is no air. So test tube D will not be generated. Since we will not be generating test tube D, this is the experiment regarding about germination. What are the factors affected here? Tell me the factors. Which is most important? Yes, only there is a liquid. That is water, air, sunlight. The sunlight region we have written here as a temperature. Okay. Now I am going to show you the pictures of test tubes live. Sir. Okay, keep the fourth one. Four test tubes, A, B, C, D. Directly. Okay, test tube four. Four test tubes at a time. Okay. Now see the first test tube we have written already on the board, but I am going to show you the clear explanation. I am going to show you the screen share. Look at the first test tube. See, seeds kept in moist cotton in warm temperature. Seeds kept in moist cotton. Moist cotton means we are giving cotton with the help of water. So it is called as moist cotton. A tube A has all rights, means everything is in the perfect mode. Condition, all rights, all right conditions such as water, oxygen and suitable temperature. What is the temperature we have given here? At 25 degrees Celsius. That is the room temperature, you can say. And it is a perfect temperature for seed germination. Germination takes place. What is the importance here? In the first test tube, the seeds are germinated. So they have written as germination takes place. Come to the second test tube, that is seeds kept in moist cotton. Where we have kept the seeds? In the moist cotton. And the temperature we kept at 0 degrees Celsius. In the test tube, because of the lack of temperature, seeds cannot be germinated in the test tube B. Come to the third picture, that is test tube C. Seeds kept in dry cotton. We have not given the water for the seeds. Test tube C is lacking of water, but we have given the temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius, as well as air is there in the test tube. Clear? So, will the seed germinate? No, seeds cannot be germinated. What about the fourth one? Fourth one is having different conditions. See in your picture. Seeds kept in the boiled water. What they have done? Yes, seeds are in the boiled temperature. And at the room temperature, we are giving more and more heat. And there is no oxygen. On the top, we are using oil. Oil reduces the content of air. So, oxygen is reduced. So, air is not there, but water and the temperature is there. So, seeds cannot be germinated. What are the three factors affected here? Water, air and temperature. That's what we have learned by testing the seeds in a test tube. Okay, we will come to the board. Okay. Now we have completed about this one. Seeds has completed. Next, all the seeds need adequate oxygen. Yes, because of this test tubes, we can understand that every seed need oxygen. How we are breathing inside the air, the same way the seeds also need oxygen. Water and the right temperature for germination. Water needed, right temperature means at 25 degrees Celsius only the seeds are getting germinated. So we need to provide seeds at 25 degrees Celsius to get germinated. We have to provide perfect water and the temperature that should be at 25 degrees Celsius for germination. Some seeds may also need a proper lighting. Lightening means either sunlight or we can do as a room temperature like 25 degrees Celsius. Next, some seeds can generate well in the presence of light, while others may require darkness to start germination. Some seeds will germinate in the morning session. If the sunlight is there, they are going to germinate. But some seeds need darkness. When the sun is set, then they are going to germinate from the soil. Okay. Some seeds germinate in morning, in the morning with the help of sunlight. Some are in night time, night or darkness. Okay. Next. Soil is needed to a plant to get nutrients. What I told you in the first while before starting the lesson, I told you soil is not needed for germination. But if the soil is there, we get water and minerals from the soil, and it is useful for seed. That's what they told us. Soil is needed for the plants to get nutrients when the seed has grown to becoming a seedling. From the seed, we have got here seed leaves. Yes, this is a tiny root-like structure. The first stage, that is a root structure. From the radical, it is coming. So for this, water and all the temperature is needed by using the soil. Next, this part is called as a seedling. The amount of the time it takes to seed to germinate depends on many factors. We have learned about the factors for germinating. Only to get into a new plant, germination is needed. Okay, but the germination is conducted in the four test tubes we have learned. Right? And what are the factors mostly affected? Water, air, and temperature. Sometimes it takes according to the soil also. Some soils are very thick in nature, some soils are sandy, some soils are in a black and very hot. And the next one, what type of a variety we are using? Variety of seeds. What variety? We are using hybrid variety or general seed or anything. It depends on the variety of seed also. Next, it depends on the climatic condition. If when the seeds are sown, if the rain has came or something like a storm, it depends on local climatic conditions. Local climatic conditions. Okay. These are the factors affecting for the germination. I will write out the code one second. Okay, first one is the most important affecting factor is water, or we can call it as a humidity. Water or moist and rain. Moist. First one affecting of the seed generation is water or the moistness of a seed. Second one, light, sunlight or temperature. If it is grown normally, sunlight is needed. If we are growing in the test tubes, we need the temperature. What is the important temperature we have seen there? Yes, at 25 degrees Celsius. The seeds are getting germinated. If the sunlight is there, whatever the amount the heat is required, the seed is going to absorb. If we are growing in the test tube, we need particular temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius. Next one, air or oxygen. Air or oxygen. Plant need to breathe or seed need to breathe. How we are breathing? The same way oxygen or air is needed for the germination. Next one, next factor, yes, variety of seed. Whether we are using the same variety or not. Means a hybrid varieties, here I am. Hybrid or normal. If we are using hybrid variety, it will take some time. If it is a normal, the seeds will be in the normal mode and it is going to germinate easy. Hybrid having somewhat thicker seed coat, so it will take some time to germinate. What is the factor affecting here? Variety of a seed. Next one, local climatic condition. Local climatic conditions. What are the local climatic conditions? If it is very hot, seed will not be grown. If it is very cold, seed will not be grown. If it is heavy cold, heavy rain, seed will not be grown. So the local climatic condition, every part of a seed is required same amount of heat, same amount of water, same amount of air or oxygen. So the local climatic condition will vary from one type of generation to next generation. Okay, next one, what we have learned is variety of the seed and climatic conditions and how we have sown. How we have sown. If the seeds are sown in a particular length or depth in a soil, then the seeds will perfectly germinate. If the seeds are sown on the above level or the top layers of the soil, they cannot be germinated. Because the seed requires some amount of a darkness which can be given by the soil. So how we have sown them? These are the most five factors affecting the germination of a seed. What is the first factor? Water or moisture. Now only we have seen in the test tubes. Already we have completed the experiment. Second one, sunlight or the temperature. At least 25 degrees Celsius. Air or oxygen. In the fourth test tube, we have given the oil on the top. Because oxygen is going to reduce with the help of oil. So if oxygen are not there for the seed will not be germinated. And next, variety of a seed, hybrid or normal. Hybrid seeds have a thicker seed coat compared to the normal seeds. Normal seed having normal seed coat. Okay, hybrid is having somewhat thicker when compared to the normal. And it will take some time to germinate. Next, local climatic conditions. What are those? Yes, no heavy rainfall should be there. Heavy rainfall. And next, no heat. Next, no heat should not be there. Temperature should be at the normal level. Normal. And low. These are the factors we are going to affect for the normal temperatures. Next, how we have sown? Deep or above the soil. If the seeds are inside the deep in the soil, it will take some time. Or it will take above soils will not be generated. So the depth of a seed. What is important? Depth of a seed. What is important? Depth of a seed is important to rise a seed into a new plant. Okay. The process of absorbing water and sunlight and the temperature is called a germination. These are the five factors affecting the germination. Okay. Now, today I am going to send you the worksheet on the factors affecting germination. Read the textbook once and write the worksheet. Be happy children, be healthy children. Take care. Bye. We will meet in the next class.